It's like our hearts have intertwined into the perfect harmony. This is why I love you. Oh, this is why I love you. Because you love me. You love me.
Who blesses this bride with their love and support on this, the day she is married? You may be seated. You may hold hands. Today, two people whose hearts have beaten for each other for as long as they can remember vow to love each other forever. Time and circumstances have changed them, but nothing has changed their hearts. And they are so thankful all of you are here to serve as witnesses to those vows. Deanna explains she has always dreamt of getting married and sharing her vows before family and friends. Derek says he just wants to share their celebration with all of you, the people they love and care for. You have always been there for them, and they hope you will always be there for them. So today they ask all of you to make a sacred vow too. They ask you to promise to always support them in their marriage. So I'm going to ask you a question, and if you so promise, when I ask it, please say loudly and together, "We do." Ready? Do you, the people who are their world, always promise to support Derek and Deanna as they make their way in the world together?
We do!
All of you have shared your love and your lives with these two. Now would you please bow your heads to share in the blessing of their marriage? Gracious God, in James 1:17, you taught us that all good things come from above. And we thank you for the love that Derek and Deanna have found in and with each other. Lord, we ask that you grant them your many blessings. Let them know patience and gentleness with each other and with each other's faults. Let them enjoy a lifetime of learning and learning about each other. Let the home they create together be filled with healthy and happy children. Adorable
Christmas. But their story is much funnier than that.
Their tradition is that everyone is allowed to open one gift on Christmas Eve. Derek and Nathan were already dressed in their Christmas pajamas, and she was about to put hers on, but they had already opened their gifts, and Derek desperately wanted her to have hers. She had a strong feeling something was up. She begged Derek to let her go get dressed for her. But he was anxious and explained he wanted to give her her gift before she got dressed. Trembling, Derek bent down on one knee, told her how much he loved her, and asked her to marry him while she was dressed only in her underwear. Derek, he says he knows it wasn't a romance novel moment, and he could have done it better. But he was so scared and nervous, and it really was a thought. And upon reflection, Deanna has come to realize that his proposal was absolutely perfect. He loves her no matter what. He decided on that day, at that very moment, to pop the question. He loves her unfiltered and in the flesh, or in her underwear. And he has loved her as long as they both can remember. So it seems fitting that that day led to this day. Marriage for you, Deanna, is the ultimate partnership. It means you are dedicated to building a life together, loving each other, and not giving up on each other through all of the good and bad times. Derek, you believe marriage is the ultimate form of love, a God-given bond that cannot be broken. It is a sacred promise to be a better person for yourself and for each other every day. Having heard each other's definitions of marriage, I ask you both most reverently, do you come willingly to be married today? Deanna, the man who stands before you is about to become your husband. This is the man you say is so very sweet and so very selfless. But most importantly, Derek is such a loving human being, and it warms your heart to know how much he loves you and Nathan. Derek has taught you to be patient. He always takes his time and is never easily overwhelmed. From him, you have learned that there is no point in stressing over something that is out of your control. He goes out of his way to make you feel secure. The only words he uses to describe you are kind and full of affection. He tells you you are beautiful. And because he treats you that way, you have come to believe you really are just that, beautiful. Ask what the most consistent feeling you have when you are with Derek is. You said he makes you feel safe and secure. You look forward to growing your family and making many, many more lovely memories with him. Derek takes care of you and Nathan. He works relentlessly to make sure your household is taken care of. You cherish the fact he is such a good provider. You see that as the ultimate act of love. Derek is also a fun, easygoing, and dedicated father to Nathan. You are so grateful for the nurturing example he provides for your son. He is also a generous fur father to your other child, Rocky the Doberman. He demands attention, and Derek spoils him with treats and toys. You both enjoy music, love your family, trying new food, traveling, and going on vacation. Derek can be simple and silly, but serious, too. Ask what you have now that you didn't have before you met Derek. You said deeper understanding, wisdom, and a beautiful boy. That said, Deanna, as freely as God has given you life, do you join your life with Derek? Do you promise that wherever he goes, you will go? And that whatever he faces, you will face? For good or ill, in happiness or sadness, come riches or poverty, you take Derek as your husband, and you promise that all of your days, from this day forward, will be Derek's days to keep.
I do.
Amen.
Derek, the woman who stands before you is about to become your wife. This is the woman who showed you how to love. In fact, she showed you what love is. She has taught you to see the good in people and to love everyone like you would like to be loved yourself. Her soul shines with goodness. She is honest and pure. Deanna lights up a room when she walks into it, and when she leaves a room, you miss her very aura. She is loyal and upfront in everything she says and does, and you know that will be the hallmark of your relationship and will keep it strong. You can talk to Deanna about anything and everything. She has an open mind and an open ear. She is the only person you can open up to fully. She never makes you feel like less of a person. That's because you can share your true self with her, secure in the knowledge that she loves you unconditionally. Deanna inspires you to be a better person and father every day. She motivates you to push yourself to be a better human being. In fact, she is your role model for parenting. You say she is the best mother you could ever ask for your son. She is full of love and goes and above and beyond for Nathan. You admit the two of you are total opposites in everything. And you went on to emphasize that by saying, literally everything. And even though you don't know why, your opposites definitely attract. Deanna is so very comfortable for you to be around. When you are with her, you feel totally safe and loved. You relish the time you spend with her at home, just sharing a meal or relaxing together. But you are also looking forward to a lifetime of new experiences with her. Ask what you have now that you didn't have before you met Deanna. You said, a loving son and a person I want to spend the rest of my life with. That said, Derek, as freely as God has given you life, do you join your life with Deanna's? Do you promise that wherever she goes, you will go? And that whatever she faces, you will face, for good or ill, in happiness and in sadness, come riches or poverty, you take Deanna as your wife, and you promise that all of your days from this day forward will be Deanna's days to keep.
Deanna and Derek, you have consecrated your hearts to one another, but there is someone else who lives there too. Nathan, will you come join your parents up front, please? Right in the middle. There you go. There is one more sacred vow to make today, perhaps more important than all of the others because it includes Nathan. So I have an important question to ask all three of you. Do the three of you always promise to be a family and to love each other and take care of each other forever?
I do. We do.
You may now kiss your son. Deanna and Derek, when asked who your role models were for marriage, both of you said Deanna's parents. So it seems fitting that I should have them share some magical marriage advice with you, based on Derek's favorite book, the Harry Potter series. Daniels.
Okay, when Lupin speaks of Lily, we are reminded that in a successful relationship, we learn how magical each of us is by the presence of a loving partner who lets us know as much and that it is our duty to remind them of the same thing. Hagrid acknowledges that while a couple may not know what lies on the path before them, what's coming will come.
You must meet it head on.
Dumbledore echoes the sentiment when he professes that you are only as strong as you can be when you are united.
And as weak as you can be when you are divided.
In other words, the two of you must form a force and face all that life will bring to you together. Couples often take one another for better or for worse, but after the wedding day, instead take each other for granted. It is a great lesson to any couple to realize indifference and neglect often do more damage than outright dislike.
Apathy for your marriage is its greatest enemy.
There is reassurance in the words. Happiness can be found even in the darkest of times, when one only remembers to turn on the light.
There will be dark times in your marriage. Remember, each of you is a light unto the other.
Finally, live your life together, so that at the end of all your days, you can honestly ask, after all this time, and truthfully answer, always.
Always. Amen. What about Derek Daddy? I got a scripture too.
Derek and Deanna.
Well, holy.
Today, the circle of love that brought you into this world, your parents and theirs, and even theirs, grows wider still as you declare your vows to one another. So it is fitting that you carry your grandmother Anna's wedding rings and your beloved Papa's dog tags today, Deanna, because they are a part of your legacy of love. They represent, just as the rings you are about to exchange will, that ever-widening. Derek, you may now salute your bride. Yeah. Wayne, will you come forward now?
And remember what peace there may be in silence. Speak your truth quietly and clearly, and listen to others, even to the dull and the ignorant. They too have a story. If you compare yourself with others, you may become vain or bitter, for always there will be greater and lesser persons than yourself. Enjoy your achievements as well as your plans. Keep interested in your own career. It is a real possession in the changing fortunes of time. Exercise caution, but let this not blind you to what virtue there is. Many persons strive for high ideals, and everywhere lies
that for the first time ever as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs.
Oh, yeah! Yeah! Oh, yeah! Oh, yeah!
Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
Yeah! All right, yeah.
Thank you. Let's go find some AC.